Hello, everybody. Flash Notion here, back with another My Little Pony reaction video. And today we're going to be taking a look at Season 9 Finale. But not Series Finale. Nope. See, because this is episodes 24 and 25 of Season 9, and it is the finale of the season proper. I know some things about the final episode, mainly that it's a sort of epilogue episode, so therefore it doesn't really count as part of the season proper, in my opinion. I'd quicker count Best Gift Ever as part of the season, sort of, but not really. Like, that's somewhere in between seasons 8 and 9. In any case, this finale is gonna be huge. Like, this, honestly, this is, hang on a second. Sorry about that. Hopefully I remember to put in a quick little cut there. But yeah, this finale is gonna be huge. This is pretty much the most season-long arc that we've had. Like, more so than season 5, definitely. More so, I'd say, than season 4 in terms of, like, making everything connect. More so than season 7, where it was more just a theme about the pillars. And, yeah, definitely way more than season 8. Like, season 8 had the school all throughout it, but, like, it wasn't an arc or a theme or really anything like that that made sense. And, like, we didn't have that much going on with Cozy Glow in Season 8. Season 9, we've had plenty. Because, yeah, we've had the first two-parter, beginning of the end. We had Twilight 7. We had definitely Frenemies was part of it. Between Dark and Dawn. Summer Sun Setback. And, I guess that's kind of it. Maybe a little bit of a horseshoe-in, kind of. And now we have this two-parter, the final two-parter of the series, the ending of the end, parts 1 and 2. Great title, of course. Very cheeky. So, this is gonna be Twilight's coronation as the Princess of Equestria. Sorry, I just knocked my desk. And there's going to be something that the villains are gonna be doing. Grogar's trying to find an artifact that he can use. The other villains, Tirek, Chrysalis, and Cozy Glow, are trying to find out how to use Grogar's bell. And from what I've seen so far, I think what the bell does is it has the power to transfer power between individuals, because it seems like different individuals are going to be getting the power of Discord in this episode. So yeah, that's going to be fun. Yeah, so other than that, I'm really looking forward to seeing how this all pans out. I don't think that it's going to end in redemption for any of our villains, for once. So, in that regard, Steven Universe has this one beat. Steven Universe has more of the magic of friendship than Friendship is Magic does. That's kind of crazy. In any case, we're opening the episode on Canterlot, so it seems we're going to be getting right into it. And we will get started in 3, 2, 1, play. Yay, we got a baker.
Hey there, my unicorn friend. Have you heard
about Princess Twilight's Sparkle?
Oh, that's Chrysalis, of course.
So much baking to do and...
No, about the Earth Ponies.
I know their crops have been underperforming, but...
That's not it. They're hoarding the food for themselves. I heard the mayor of Appaloosa say that if unicorns and pegasi want to eat, they can use their own host to dig.
How awful!
We unicorns have to stick together, right?
Wow. Yeah, that's far too easy.
Ah, Chrysalis. Another successful field trip, I presume?
Spreading distrust among the unicorns and earth ponies is...
This feels like a Sirens thing that she's more doing.
Twilight and her friends 100 times, but as long as they have the love of Equestria behind them, they crawl back to defeat us. Not anymore.
I mean, that's not how it really works. They have each other's friendship.
I did my part freaking out the Pegasi.
And Glogar's long absence has given me time to prepare the next part of our plan.
Oh, cool.
Glogar's bell. This artifact can steal any creature's magic. It holds that magic until it is released by this spell. Which means all the power inside is ours for the taking.
There's no power in it.
You're drooling on the bell.
Ew.
Let's try the spell before Grogar gets back. I'm sick of waiting for that old goat's master plan.
Take my hands. So we can all be part of the spell. Well. Unless you'd prefer...
Maybe T-Rex is gonna be reformed.
Our path stands.
Wow.
We do together. Once we defeat the protector of Equestria, we can claim this land and rule.
Guardians of Harmony.
Alone once more.
Until you betray each other and attack each other and whatnot. Okay. Whoa. Oh, okay. That's unsettling. So, Alicorn Cozy Glow and Chrysalis's wings looked a little more perky. And, yeah, T-Rex is buffer. So, apparently there's a lot of magic stored in there. Who knew? Let's see what else ended up going on. See, but that's the thing, isn't it? Like, the magic of friendship isn't just, like, the main six's magic. It's a more ancient, innate thing that has nothing to do with their individual statuses.
Twilight Sparkle's coronation is today, and we are going to ruin it with this artifact. But to succeed,
what is it?
You must work together.
They're not there.
Way ahead of you, Grogar.
Oh. Your aim's a little off, Cozy. Chrysalis's design looks epic.
You had it all this time? Why didn't you tell me?
We're villains, duh.
Ooh, and they're using it on him. Ooh. Wait, what? What?
Unexpected.
Yeah, what? Discord
was Grogar like the whole time. Should we follow him?
Without magic, he's no threat. Besides, we have plans.
Yeah, I like Chrysalis' new design. So, was Discord trying to reform them by faking them out and pretending to be Grogar?
Grown up. Should we tell her that we've cleared out our royal suite so she and Spike can move in?
Oh, maybe wait until after the coronation.
Hauling away the thrones.
So, you freaking out yet?
About nope. That?
Oh, I don't know. It's not every day the princesses that have ruled Equestria for hundreds of moons retire and pass all their responsibilities on to you and your friends.
Oh, that. Actually, I'm feeling pretty good.
She's had a while to accept it.
There's nothing we can't handle together. Which reminds me,
something for Spike? Aww, an official title. Aww, this is adorable. Oh shoot! Alarm. Oh, that's not good. I'll have to remember to take care of that after this. Well, yeah.
We have some royal errands to run.
Yay! but the city's a ghost town.
And you sure this is where Pinky told us to get the blackberries for her special coronation dessert? Maybe they keep their produce in the back?
Nope, this is all we got. But I got a special on these taters.
Ew.
No thank you. We'll keep looking.
More.
Ooh, Twilight, darling. You're just in time. Only one more pre-coronation stop. We're picking up the final touch for your après hors d'oeuvre gown.
Is that before or after the Royal Marshmallow Eating Contest gown?
What? I haven't made one of those. You must tell me when they add these sorts of things.
It's okay, Rarity. I was just joking.
Joking? Deliver coronation?
Rarity wins. Aw. Oh dear.
God, they look open.
What do you want?
Oh, well, this being a thread shop, I thought I might buy some?
Put the bits in the mail slot.
What the heck?
What was that about?
You know, designers don't like being interrupted when they're on a creative roll. Ooh, a thread this exquisite, can you blame them?
Weather for the coronation is sunny skies.
It was weird, though. Not many Pegasi wanted to help me clear the clouds. They were kind of on edge.
They're not the only ones.
It's the first shift in royal power in over a millennium. Of course.
And tribal tensions are high.
But I'm That's... sure it's not because
yeah.
I'm worried about you.
How could they be? How many times have you saved their flanks by now?
I don't even want to count, actually. It's too many.
We'll make sure things stay the same.
Yeah, about that.
Twilight! There you are! You mind telling your friend here that I don't need an official guard wherever I go? Especially if he ain't gonna help carry apples?
I appreciate you taking such good care of my friends, but we're fine now.
That's the strangest thing. He kept calling me Earth Pony, like I didn't have a name. And watching me like he thought I'd steal
the
silver.
Really, Pinky?
Go in that kitchen. You look like you were in a sugar war.
For some reason, the bakers are super grouchy with each other. That unicorn chef started throwing dessert at Mrs. Cake. I tried to help.
Oh, wow.
Tasty, tasty crossfire.
Oh, wow.
Pre-coronation nerves.
Oh, my aching metatarsals. You know, you forget how convenient snap travel is.
Wait, did you just walk here on foot?
Yeah.
Actually, and I have a confession to make. You see, I might have made the teeniest boo-boo. All very well intentioned and
he was trying to reform them.
Get to the point, Discord.
You remember that whole thing with King Sombra? That was slightly my fault, and by slightly I mean I brought him back.
You did? But why?
Well, it seemed like a good idea at the time, which is why I also brought back three other villains who are now on the loose and not really big fans of yours. So my bad.
Wow, Discord, wow. That's why he was so... Oh my... That was why he was doing the thing in that episode. Summer Sunset Back.
Look what a great job you did defeating Sombra. All the confidence you gained. Remember the cheering, the hoof bumps?
Okay, maybe you didn't do it.
For all the time you spent with us, you really haven't picked up too much in the way of friendship lessons, huh?
You've been setting up challenges for us the whole time, haven't you? None of our successes were actually real.
Of course they were. You just had an extremely good-looking safety net.
And how was that supposed to help again?
I intended to prepare Twilight for anything by orchestrating an epic attack at her coronation.
You beastly beast!
Twilight!
Well...
You don't take a final exam on your first day of class. Just think, after defeating three baddies, Twilight would have to believe that she's the leader we all know she is.
You have made a grave misjudgment, Discord. do you have anything else you would like to tell us?
Would you like the good news or the bad news?
That wasn't the bad news.
My chaos magic is gone, trapped in Grogar's bell.
Oof.
What's the good news?
Chrysalis, T-Rex, and Cozy Glow now have all of the real Grogar's magic.
Oh.
What world is that good news?
Compared to me losing my powers, anything else is good news.
Yeah, kinda.
Maybe it's not too late to stop this disaster from happening.
I need some time to think first.
Well, there isn't any.
Yeah, she has. This is a lot to process.
Oh, just listen to my voice and use your imagination. Let the fool go. Without magic, he's no threat. Besides, we have plans. Lame Six is so busy being perfect, they haven't even noticed what we've been up to. Have I mentioned how great revenge is?
Oh, I hope you got a name picked up.
Wow. You
know, because it's time to destroy Equestria.
Wow.
They're probably on their way to attack Canterlot right now.
Then we'll stop them.
How? Stopping Sombra by himself was hard enough. And that
part
of Chaos Training Wheels.
Twilight.
You didn't defeat him with Discord.
Set up your successes or not. We believe in you.
They were still successes.
Lean on your strengths to counter your weaknesses.
My strengths?
Your friends. Even Discord.
Spike! Send a letter to Star Swirl. Tell him we need the pillars to guard the borders of Canterlot.
Ooh! Nice!
We'll have one waiting for them. With Chrysalis on the loose, she'll go after Starlight. Warren Cain.
Good point.
Shining armor. There are fire line of defense if we fail.
Nice.
Ultimate battle for the fate of Equestria is coming.
What about the rest of the kingdoms?
You two stop arguing.
Like the hippogriffs and the
he's red.
T-Rex?
Close enough.
He's not as annoying as I expect.
It's a good start.
We should take the magic inside it. You know how powerful Discord. That much chaos magic in our veins?
But taking yeah. it all would be madness. It's impossible for any other creature to control.
I guess.
As you would know. Like, that's probably why he went so crazy at the end and just started randomly destroying things. Okay! That's a bad idea, though. Okay. Yeah, I can't exactly do it right. That's awesome.
I still think chaos magic is a good idea.
Leave it in the bell. We've got a kingdom to conquer.
So, where we strike first?
Everywhere.
Ooh. That's a good point. There are three of them. They can split up.
That wouldn't be possible without all of you.
You're welcome.
Dude, read the room.
Whoa. Did I just see an animation error?
What is our biggest battle yet? All of Equestria is at stake. And I can't do this alone. But I'm not afraid. Because with friendship as our armor and teamwork as our power, no pony can ever bring us down.
Oh, come on! Where'd you get that? A daily affirmations calendar?
Yes.
Cozy Glow?
I mean, if she wrote it herself.
Wipe the floor with you!
Ow! And also, that was rainbow colored.
Wow, it's true. Alicorns really do have more fun.
Nice.
Spread out and stay ready. Canterlot depends on us.
I mean, big borders to cover. I like seeing them all there, though. Like, wow. T-Rex. Remember him, Star Swirl? Yeah. Whoa! Now that's some Earth Pony strength right there, definitely. Oh, and this is just the warm-up. And he's draining them all. Dang it.
Magic seasoned with age.
No. Poor shovel. Aww. Poor Rockhoof. That's his voice? That's great. Oof. Yeah, she's no Rainbow Dash. Wow. Evacuating all the students to the underground. Where's Starburst? Sunburst. He should have been there too, right? Oh, this ought to be good. You didn't make an appointment. Ooh. Into the this place. Somewhere you can't hurt any pony. Wrong. I can hurt you. That is all she wants. Is this next to her old village? That wouldn't make sense. For Starlight to take her there.
You'll pay for that. Put it on my tab.
Jeez, she's awesome. This is the first time we've seen Starlight do a real magic battle, and she looks so awesome there. Oof, but Chrysalis has way too much power. Ugh.
Now I'll have all eternity to take my revenge on you.
Yeah, I do not want to imagine what that would be. Oof. That's different. I haven't seen Alicorns open a portal. Yeah, you're facing three Alicorns. Oof.
Ready, sister? Wait. What are you?
Oh, she has the bell. That's not good. Yeah. Her having the bell means that was oof.
You're so reliant on all your special power, you forget to use your brain. Keep telling yourself that. Now!
Whoa! That was awesome. Sweet! That was the best. Spike, too. Nice. Wow. We haven't seen Spike use his, nice. Uh-oh. T-Rex and Chrysalis. Discord's just hiding back there.
You think your pathetic shield can stop us? The pillars have
been. I like the hexagonal stuff.
Is abandoned. Face it, Twilight. You've lost.
You can attack us, and we may fall, but Equestria will still stand, united in friendship. And we won't
about
stop
that. Yeah, Chrysalis and Cozy have been.
Something was wrong in Equestria. We've been busy.
A whisper here, a rumor there.
Destroy some crops, cause some damage.
Turn pony against pony.
Until your whole kingdom is on edge, waiting for just one tiny thing to push them over the brink.
There's no backup friends or rainbow magic to save you now.
Go.
Is there? Oh!
You know what's stronger than friends?
Ooh.
You have to protect yourself. You don't have time for any pony else.
Too bad you never taught that in school.
Whoa, whoa. Nicely done, Rarity. Aw, even Discord. That is, how is that piece of rock even still intact? Wow. That was intense. And can I just say, most action-packed episode ever? Like, normally they save the big action-y moment for the second episode. Even Twilight vs. Tyrek, that was in the second half. This is... What's the finale, like the final battle gonna be like? That was insane! Alright, let's get through the recap. Uh-oh, that was weird. Probably gonna be a couple second delay.
Not every day, the princess is
but yeah.
Responsibilities onto you and your friends? You wanted to boost Twilight's confidence, so you brought back Chrysalis, Cozy Glow, and T-Rex to attack her?
That was a cool reveal. Not the whole time. That was surprising. Like, the destruction of the castle like that. That was... Wow. Immediately into the song. That's just... It does not fit at all. Does not fit at all. Oh, this is gonna be good. And yeah, we have to get... That's where she's gonna go! She's gonna get the hippogriffs, the dragons, the... Changelings, and the griffins, and the yaks, and probably some other ponies as well. Because, like, we didn't see Cadence in Shining Armor. So, yeah. Ah, this is gonna be so good. This is gonna be so good.
And now, for your complete destruction! Won't that be fun?
Patience, Cozy. I love her expressions. And written by Michael Vogel. I love it.
We should have fun with our guests.
Ooh.
No, we should hunt down Twilight Sparkle. As long as she's out there, she's dangerous.
Is that big, strong Minotaur that scared of one little pony?
Minotaur.
Relax. It's not like her friends are.
He's a centaur.
The fools brought the remains of my throne to Canterlot to protect themselves. Those shards block their magic. Careful, too close, and the shards cancel even our powers.
True.
But on this side of the cavern, we're the most powerful beings in Equestria. Thanks to Grogar's bell. Isn't that right, Grogar?
Oof. Wow.
What are you doing? You saw
it's still tempting.
Discord's chaos magic.
Yeah, but there's Alicorn princess magic in there now.
What do you mean you could be?
Yeah.
I'm the best one out of all of us. Nobody sees
me. But then that was T-Rex expressions. Yeah. Especially since no matter how bad their infighting gets, they'll sort it out.
Any idea how we get out of here to do that?
Ugh.
There's no way any pony could get through this.
I'm so sorry. It made so much sense in my head. Twilight defeats her enemies and is filled with confidence. I truly did have the best intentions. I swear.
Well, we all know
that's gonna need to be a
what road that paves.
Stay away from the bell. Yes. None of us can use the Alicorn's magic until we figure out how to handle that fool's ridiculous chaos magic.
I could always tell you. It would give you power over all reality, but you'd have to ask nicely and spare my friends.
No, Discord! This isn't the way to help! Discord, could you please?
Threats are more my speed. Speak!
He's lying. He won't tell us.
I certainly won't tell you after the way you lied to me last time we teamed up, you muscle-bound.
True. Ooh. He has some serious cojones there.
You're right. Cretan is too polite. How about pathetic centaur who uses magic?
Oh, they got it right that time.
In fact, deep down, he's afraid he'll never be enough to please dear old dad.
Ooh. Oh, mentioned his king. There's dad. And my name.
You missed, did he though?
Ooh, Starlight's free. Nice. Oh, she's a troll. I love her. Nice. Ouch.
Twilight, we may not have our magic, but we aren't completely helpless. We'll hold them off as long as we can.
That was a pretty epic makeup.
Just save Equestria.
Wow, just marry her already. He's gonna... Wow. Nice.
Why are you out in the open? Hide!
Where is every pony?
The unicorns have been gathering in Celestia's School of Magic ever since the attack. That's where I was headed when I saw you.
What about the Earth ponies and Pegasi?
It's every pony for themselves.
Hey, jerk.
Well, you can all stand out here and debate. I'm going where I'm safe.
Fair.
They really have turned ponies against each other.
Eh, it won't last.
Scared, that's all. We just need to get to Ponyville and find Twilight prompt. She'll know
how do you know she's in Ponyville? Like, that's an obvious place to go. She wouldn't go there. Ooh, I saw that snowflake. Are the Wendigos gonna come back?
Because Ponyville's own heroes of Equestria are here to save us.
Yay, sort of.
First pony's been pouring in looking for somewhere safe.
We don't have unicorn magic to protect us. We're a city in the sky to hide in like those cowardly Pegasi.
Cowardly? They're blocking clouds down.
So they ooh. Put
grounded ponies up in their business. Listen up, buddy.
Don't. That's exactly what
buddy. That's a female.
Are you better fix this?
Yeah. Well,
Twilight's probably as worried as every pony else and trying to find somewhere safe. That's why I was sure she'd be waiting for us in Ponyville. Where else could she be?
Like a dozen places?
Oh, thanks, Celestia.
Nope.
Right. She's upstairs. It's not good.
Oh. Twilighting hard? How?
They made a terrible mistake. You halted. From the second I got away, I've been searching every book, scroll, and spell for a way to rescue you and stop Chrysalis, T-Rex, and Cozy, but I haven't found anything. I failed.
You'll come up with something.
We can't save Equestria without you.
I mean, you literally deus ex machina all the time. Because they don't know what to do.
Sombra, returned and destroyed the Tree of Harmony. Chrysalis, T-Rex, Cozy Glow, returned and more powerful than ever. The School of Friendship, shut down. Every pony in Equestria is so blinded by fear they can't remember what friendship is. Nothing we do makes any difference.
Yeah, and reforming Discord, accidentally caused all of this. Never say that! Yeah, the Wendigos are back. Yeah.
The Wendigos! That's just a heartwarming Eve story. Creatures made of wind that spread cold and misery across the land to punish ponies? Seems pretty real to me.
Yeah.
I guess I deal with this. There's nothing we can do except hide.
And the students are gonna save it.
We can't control it, and we can't rely on those snooty unicorns for any help. Build up the cloud bank. We'll try to block it.
Wow.
Every pony down below.
They're on their own. We all are.
Also, where are the CMC?
Fortify the shields around the school of magic.
Oh.
We need to protect ourselves.
Hey. It's all we can do. Where are all them doing her? Nice.
Something?
So the youngins are gonna team up there.
You want the truth, Twilight? Bad things happen. No matter what you do, there's never gonna be a time when everything's perfect. But that don't mean you quit trying.
What if I make things
worse? Are they bringing episode 5 into this? I don't like that episode, but
I've been gaining confidence. Then I find out it's all a lie.
Well, not a lie. It's just a well,
I probably know more about being scared than any pony.
Aww.
I've learned I'm always less scared when I'm with my friends.
If we're facing good, the boss good. Gods, we're facing them together. It's what we always do, darling.
But we're on our own, and we have no idea what to do.
That's true pretty much every time something terrible is about to happen.
We don't have the element
yeah.
of harmony anymore. How can you
we never needed them.
Believe you can do this? We do. We believe in you. In us.
The truth is, all our lives wouldn't be the same if we hadn't met. We're better off because of our friendship with you. So when you say you haven't made a difference, that's just not true. You've made a big difference to us.
Aww.
Thank you.
Crying again for an entirely different reason.
Reminder that there's more to the magic of friendship than rainbow lasers.
Although that part is pretty cool.
Yeah. Especially since you can do it without the elements of harmony.
That sounds like the pony I used to full sit for.
And she's ready for a fight.
No, you need to stay here and protect Gloryheart. If we don't,
aw. Yeah, you gotta be parents first. Oh. Okay. Wow.
have taken over. Powered up by ancient magic. Every pony in Equestria is so scared and divided that the Wendigos are circling. And it's up to us to fix it all.
Yeah. Binky's,
try to save the world.
There is no try. There's only do.
We can hunt down the rest of the Wendigos?
I'm not hunting any pony down in this weather. Can't we magically get rid of them and warm things up?
I don't think we should. This could work out quite well for me.
You mean us.
The harsh weather is the final blow to break the pony's spirits.
Yeah.
Is a frozen wasteland.
She's not wrong.
Magic to destroy those windy beasts. Ponies will be so grateful they'll do whatever I want.
The Wendigos are ancient magic. It would be unwise to leave them unchecked. Best we
true.
Deal with them now.
We probably should deal with Twilight and her friends before anything else.
I thought it was too cold for you to hunt any pony down.
We don't need to. They're right there!
Yeah, coming at ya.
We're here?
Yes. Ooh, that's cool. Oh, if they'd come through in single file, that would have been perfect match to Thanos in Avengers Infinity War trailer. Ah. Break the bell! Well, I think somebody else can. Somebody that I know is going to get it eventually.
Can we get on with this, please?
Ooh, dang.
We need to get that bell and get Discord and the princesses their magic back. Rainbow Dash, Pinky, you're with me.
Sweet, I'll grab that bell in 10 seconds.
No, we're the distraction. They're going to get the bell.
Okay, I mean, kind of makes sense. Pinky's very distracting. Head on charge! Nice! You're mine, T-Rex! Oof! Oh, whoa!
Eh.
Wow. It's like, where did she even get that? Almost had it. Oh no, Spike! Ooh, Brady had a diamond shield. That was an equestria. Ooh, Spike! Brady and Spike working together. Oh, it didn't work. Yeah, it doesn't work like that. About that.
Enough.
Well, maybe not. Dragon's wings get plucked. Ooh, please. He just got those.
Weakness. A fitting end to your pathetic
about
story.
Yeah, you really think that?
We face it together.
Yeah. Yeah, no.
Can I open my eyes? You sure can.
Oh. That's not Twilight.
Me?
Whoa. Tempest! Holy! What am I seeing? That deserves endgame level music. Yak stomp! Go! Yes! Griffins, dragons. This is even better than the Tribes United. Hey, Pharynx.
I know how long the unicorn shield will hold.
That's all the unicorns together. The students did it. Yay! Yeah. Oh, those were his parents.
We all know the story of Heartswarming Eve. We can defeat the Wendigos together. You really think if we all sing a couple?
Nice
of
sandbar.
We'll be fine?
Get on your soapbox.
Not just singing that saved the founders of Equestria. It's what it represented.
Earth ponies, unicorns, and Pegasi become.
Aww, little children, their hope. Aww, this is amazing. Oh, and those were Rarity's parents. I saw those. Saw them. Hi, Derpy. And that was Sky Stinger. I bet Vapor Trail was in there somewhere, too. Hey, Basil. Come on, show me Gilda. I see her there.
Were we really happy by ourselves at the bottom of the ocean? Be honest.
There they are, Sky Stern. Everything. All the movie characters. I just. Wait. Where are Capper and Solano and them? I want to see them too. If you're doing it this far, I mean, we've seen Cap. Ow. Oh, Flimflam Brothers are there, too. That's surprising. Yeah, they're just... Ooh, that was awesome. Too powerful.
Enough! Because of you, I almost lost my way. But every creature here has reminded me of the true power of friendship. There will always be darkness in the world.
There will always be those who find the light. This is going to be the biggest friendship laser ever.
That's why they create the elements.
She's able to summon them?
The elements showed me and my friends how strong
Ooh.
Our friendship
is. She's empowering them because she's the element of magic.
There will always be more to do, which is why we teach others about the magic of friendship. Others who will continue our mission after we are gone. Now I truly understand.
The pillars, the student six, the elements, right, plush guardians. I just love seeing Tempest there. Together. Rainbow lasers! Oof!
This is bad, isn't
it? Yes! This is very bad for you! Oh! And destruction of Gogard's spell. You're as weak as you've ever been. And you're facing an army. You
think friendship will save you? We will always return. Nothing will ever stop
you. Chocolate rain. The power didn't exactly go. Wow.
Maybe I should.
Yeah, no.
Later, there's some chaos in my zoo.
Of course he knows how to use the bell properly.
There isn't a punishment worthy of all you've done. Oh, that does seem fitting.
May I?
Wow. Absolutely. Oof. Well, the guard's getting two statues.
Forever. I can't think of any that they would want less.
On the one hand, awesome. On the other hand, poor Cozy.
I had high hopes.
Like, she's gonna, they're aware of everything. We know that much. So, when they did that to Discord, they were just using the elements as a power source for it. It was their own intention to do it. Interesting.
You know what? I think I am.
Thank goodness. First question, Your Highness. What do we do with all these creatures?
We're gonna need a lot more chairs for the coronation.
Actually, yep.
As ruler of Equestria, I'd like to postpone the coronation for a while.
Yeah.
Besides,
yeah, that too. Or you could just ask Discord to take care of it.
Post-apocalyptic donuts.
Hey, Joe.
I know, but there's gonna be plenty of
and Pinky's Mile High Stack.
I just want to spend a quiet moment with the six best friends I've ever had.
Aww.
Mostly quiet.
It's like the end of an era.
Hey. I don't even know how to analyze this. This was the most epic thing ever. Dang. So, what? I'm having trouble processing. Just, that was so cool. That was, that was literally one of the coolest things I've ever seen. Okay. So, yeah, at some point, expect an edit of that final battle scene in which Portals plays.
Thank you.
And also maybe some of the music from or other parts of the movie, like from the big three there versus Thanos. Yeah, just wow, that was so cool. Everything about that was so cool. And yeah, I'm kind of glad, you know, I on the one hand there might be some people who feel cheated by what they did with by them making Grogar into Discord. On the other hand, I feel like it works. Like, the idea that that Grogar has been just biding his time in the shadows for 1,000 years, like, it, well, more than 1,000 years, it's like several thousand years, an epoch ago. Like, it really does, stretch credulity a little bit. Just, like, there's been so many other villains that just... them not realizing that Grogar was still out there and still capable of being a threat. Like, yeah, no, he's gone. And apparently the way that he was gone was because Gusty the Great, I think it was, used his own bell against him and drained all of his power. Which, cool! That's amazing! I love it. But, yeah, like, it kind of tightens up the story a bit and removes some potential loose endings and very quickly manages to make it like, okay, yeah, we're not going to have to deal with both Grogar and these three, and we're not reforming Grogar, we're sidestepping a little bit. It was well worth the misdirect, I think. It worked quite well. And... like, the moment... The episode started off with something that awesome as that reveal and that misdirect and all of that. And then it just kept going. I really did feel like I was watching Infinity War and Endgame again with how much it kept just building up. Because we went from that to... let's see, a fight against Cozy Glow, we had a fight against Tirak, we had a fight against Chrysalis, several different fights, all of which were absolutely epic and action-packed. And then, you know, we got through all that, and then we get to the end where the first part, where the villains actually, you know, succeed, as they usually do, and they just, they force Twilight to flee, which, I'll admit, it does seem kind of... like, why couldn't they have done what they did in the premiere? I have to ask that. But, as we all kind of know, the magic of friendship is kind of fickle in that it never seems to manifest the same way twice. Which, actually, is kind of interesting. Like, if that's a hard-set rule that... outside, like, barring the use of the elements of harmony, the magic of friendship can never be utilized the same way twice. That actually seems like a pretty cool rule for them to have had in the background of the show. Because, like, it was used the same way on Discord twice by different ponies, granted there. But otherwise, like, even then, though... the way that it was utilized against Discord looked slightly different in season 2 than it did in the flashback from season 4. So there is also that. but yeah, just in general, every time we've seen the magic of friendship be used, it's been utilized slightly differently, and this was no exception to that. And I really do like that. So yeah, if they couldn't do it the same way, okay, I accept that. In fact, I'm making that my personal headcanon, that they literally couldn't do it the same way. They had to find a new way to do it, because that's part of the magic of friendship. So yeah, Twilight had to flee. That was the end of the episode. And then we started out the next episode with them escaping in another action sequence, which was just spectacular and full of character. And that was just great. And then... we had them searching around for Twilight, and we got to see some different stuff going down, and, you know, the hints, or, like, the different tribes doing their thing and being mad at each other, but then coming, like, sowing the seeds of doubt there a little bit. The Wendigos coming back, like, actually, number one, confirming that the Wendigos are real, fully real. So, yeah, that's good. And then we, got Twilight a little bit more, and then we got her and her friends going to confront the villains. We had some awesomeness there. Like, that one in itself was a cool battle scene. And then we had all the heroes show up, and they didn't all fight. I kind of would have liked to have seen Ember and Tempest and all of them take part in the battle a little bit more. And, like, I don't know, it would have been kind of cool if somehow, like, Tirek, Cozy Glow, and Chrysalis had gotten minions. Like that's one of the big things, like, that the Avengers and whatnot, like, generally speaking, they do a good job of making the main villain compelling, but for the sake of, you know, an exciting climax, they tend to have an army that the various characters can fight against and show off a little bit. And here, it was just the three of them, and our heroes had the army, so it's kind of like, yeah, we needed minions, and we didn't get them. So, like, it would have been, like, you know, you couldn't have Sombra still there, because if you did have Sombra still there, then they wouldn't be proper minions, they would just be brainwashed ponies. So, how could they have done it? Like, maybe created somehow? Plunder Seeds type thing? Maybe, sounds gross, but, like, Chrysalis spawning more changelings? That would have been, there would have been some issues with how that was, but maybe she could have used her cloning magic type thing to make the more Mean Six copies. Like, that never came back yet, so that would have been kind of a cool thing for her to do. Maybe they could have been shown conquering other places before marching on Canterlot, and, like, gaining allies in that sense. Maybe T-Rex's home country, or I'm trying to think of where else they could have gone. Like, maybe Kludgetown? I don't know. Because, like, there's not that many characters that we haven't, or, like, places that we have, you know, bad characters just gathering. So, I don't know where all they could have gone for minions, but maybe they could have spawned rock golems. Like, Tirek had so much power there. Maybe they could have used the bell to imbue the ground itself with various magics. Who knows? Like, there are a dozen ways that they could have just randomly had an army of minions for the heroes to fight against. Which, okay, granted, that would have maybe necessitated, like, an extra 5 to 10 minutes somewhere. But hey, I would have gladly sacrificed episode 22 in order to have a 3-part finale before the last actual episode. Seriously, I would have done that easily. And yeah, I'm trying to think, is there any other episode that I would have sacrificed for that? Maybe she talks to Angel, but I mean, that one had some fun stuff in it too, some redeeming qualities to it. Episode 22 didn't really have any. And even episode 5 had a few redeeming qualities to it, so yeah. And she's all yak, like, that one's just my own personal problem. That one, objectively speaking, has nothing wrong with it. So, yeah. But, I mean, yeah, so I would have gladly taken out some episode that I did not care for, in order to create a third part of this, so just so that we could have had an extra half hour of time in which our heroes could beat up the bad guys and be awesome. Oh, wow. But, you know what? Plenty of awesome moments elsewhere. And then, of course, we got the big friendship power moment where we had the pillars, we had the elements, and we had the student six all together. The three different generations and groups coming together and using their friendship magics to blast the bad guys and defeating them, draining them of all their magics, redistributing that. Ah! And just, like, Twilight's demonstration of how powerful she is, as the element of magic. Completely bypassing Chrysalis's throne, which should have been impossible, teleporting all of those different characters out onto the field without the usual teleport magic, mind you. They just sort of phased through existence a little bit there, and just empowering them, giving them apparently part of her own magic in order to sustain themselves for a while. Because Discord was flying around before he got his stuff back from the bell. And, yeah, that was just all really cool. Also, they didn't have to put in Chaos Magic Pinkie Pie, but they did that just to, I guess, confirm that even Pinkie can't handle it. Okay, that's fine. I guess it could also have been just a case of proving that Pinkie is nowhere near the level of reality warper / fourth wall observer that Discord is. So, yeah, there's that as well. And, yeah, just so much craziness. I love it. I love it so much. And, like, yeah, that punishment at the end, like, the putting them into stone for a while. Yeah, I kind of would like to, I don't know, like, it kind of sucks that they don't get reformed, but on the other hand, given how much reformed villains we've had, not just in this, but in Equestria Girls as well, it is kind of refreshing to just have that villain that you can't reform them. I mean, we'd kind of had that with the Storm King and Sombra, but, like, this is a little bit different. These are characters who have shown the potential for reform, but they reject it on principle, which is pretty cool. And the fact that they reject it on principle makes it that much more satisfying to end them, rather than, you know, characters like the Storm King and Sombra, frankly, who didn't even really get the chance. Like, they weren't offered a redemption at any point in time. I am also a little bit disappointed in the part, though, that, like, I kind of was hoping that the entire reason why Discord was doing this was because he was just like, you know, maybe I could reform some villains myself, you know? Like, it would have been cool if he had that idea and he did this, not really thinking about the potential ways it could go wrong. Yeah, and also, Grogar being Discord, it works in the sense that I feel like the real Grogar, with that eye thing there, he would have known that these other villains were going to betray him and take the bell. But as we've seen, he has kind of a blind spot with that, especially when it comes to Tirek. So, like, yeah, it makes sense that Discord wouldn't really think about that, and therefore they're able to do it, which, yeah, it kind of sucks that Discord is accidentally causing all of this, but, you know, yeah, he has not redeemed himself. Discord, I don't think, will ever reach the level of redemption for all of his actions, but he's reformed, and he genuinely does want to do good, and I suppose it must be pointed out that when he doesn't have his magic and he's a purely physical being, he was actually risking his life to help the ponies right there. For no other reason than because he likes them, which is, yeah, I mean, that's impressive, actually. Go Discord. So, yeah, that's, yeah. Man. That just blows my mind a little bit to think about. And I'm sure there's going to be other moments like that blow my mind the more I think about them. But, like, the biggest thing for me was just the inclusion of the movie characters. Seeing Tempest there, Fizzlepop, I always forget that. Since, in fanfics and stuff, she's usually called Tempest. Nobody really uses her real name, but, whatever. So yeah, Fizzlepop was there, and we had to see, Queen Novo and Princess Skystar a little bit there, which, yes! Like, what is so hard about that? Just showing these characters in the background. We had, like, the only other time we did that was with Capper in, episode 13. Like, it wasn't that hard. Why couldn't they have done that more? Or something like that more? Yeah. Honestly, I think the most surprising thing about that finale, though, was, seeing the Flim Flam brothers show up there. Like, they have never been fully reformed, and yet they show up there at the end, showing that I guess they're not so bad after all. Maybe. Under the right circumstances. When they're being pressured. If we don't help save Equestria, that means that all of our bits are gonna be gone. That was my best Flim Flam impression, and it sucked. Oh, wow. So yeah, just in general, this was a pretty good, pretty good. This was an amazing two-parter, and as the finale of the season, spectacular, but I'm really looking forward to seeing what the final episode of the series has to offer as well. And yeah, I could sit here and gush over every little detail of this finale. I mean, the inclusion of Naysay in all of this. Also, I kind of caught Naysay giving Tempest a look. I would love to read a fanfiction involving Tempest and Naysay trying to get along with each other. I feel like that would be hilarious and awesome at the same time. Unfortunately, I'm not going to write that. At least not anytime soon. But yeah, I would love to read that. And yeah, just great, great episode. And no way it could ever be ranked among the normal episodes. Like, as great as Frenemies was, as hilarious as it was, and the song was good, it in no way can compare to this. Like, all of Frenemies was equal to maybe 5 minutes of this finale. So, in terms of how awesome it was. So, yes. As much as I would love to continue just gushing about that, I do have something to do, right now, and, yeah, I'm gonna let you guys go, and, I'll see you in episode 26, whenever I get around to that. Oh.